Welcome back to Danganronpa, everybody. We're starting back from the trial. Interrupt the intermission. Go ahead.
Hey, Monami. And my heart is throbbing like crazy right now. To think that the person who killed the wonderful Mahiru Kozumi is in this room. Impossible! Impossible! That's so impossible! There's no way I can believe that! I can't do anything! How annoying! But I'm just gonna believe in everyone! That's the least I can do! Everyone, do your best! Don't lose to yourselves, and don't forget to save regularly!
Saving? What's that? What's saving? I don't know what
saving
is. That's
something we don't know.
Yeah.
Well, now that we've decided to leave Hyoko, now what? If the killer was luring Hyoko into a trap, then something that was used there might be a clue.
Do you mean the letter?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
No, I do not know the Muffin Man.
The one on Drury Lane?
Nope, don't know him.
Well, no, it was probably the gummy.
Should I know him?
You should, but whatever. Huh? Candy can be a clue?
Fuyuhiko seems perturbed.
Perturbed. Hey, when you woke up, was the gummy already there? Now that you mention it, I feel like it wasn't. Just as I thought. Just as you thought?
You thought?
You thought? If the killer planted evidence while Hyoko was there, she would have thrown it away if she found it.
Duh. Which means the gummy was placed inside the closet after Hyoko fled from the beach house. Bitch ass.
The killer returned to the scene of the crime? After I left?
I just said that. They would not have to do what? Something that troublesome. You need to open your ears, lady. As long as they hid somewhere within, I'm going to need you to stop interrupting me. The beach house.
You said head somewhere. It's hid. That's impossible. There's nowhere to hide. I even glanced inside the shower room as I was running away, but there was nobody there.
Then, does that mean the killer came back?
I wonder.
I wonder?
No! War flashbacks. At any rate, the solution to that problem is connected to what really happened. That's what I think. She's right. This might be a very important problem. If the killer tampered with the evidence after Hyoko ran away from the beach house, when did the killer arrive and depart from the beach house? Brain blast, think. Oh, if I just focus and think about it, I'm sure I'll be able to find the answer.
I don't think the brain blast has happened quite yet.
It did not. All right, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna brain blast.
I'm gonna brain blast.
Gonna brain blast.
I'm good at these, 100%. I'm really good at these.
Oh, we're about to die.
No, okay, there we go.
Let's do this.
I always have to play around with the blood-ins to make sure I'm doing the right thing.
I'm glad you're playing around with the blood-ins.
Yep.
I would hate if you played around with the buttons.
Yeah, I know, right?
Hate that.
I don't think they would appreciate me playing around with the buttons.
Only amateurs do that. When did the killer arrive at the beach house? Before Hyoko arrived. Right?
I actually have no idea to correct you or not. Okay, good.
Yes, I was like, I think so. Because they had to knock her out, probably.
Well, yes, they did do that, actually. Right. That was a thing that happened.
We're smart.
Big brain.
Big brain. Question 2. When did the killer leave the beach house?
Oh, I'm
after,
out of time.
After. Because they had to throw away the, they had to set the gummy there, I mean.
Yes, you're right.
Dang, I'm on fire.
You're doing so good at answering the questions. I'm just the mule that fucking makes this thing go.
Yes, you are. What was the color hiding while Kyoko's unconscious? Beach house. Right?
Yes.
Like, I would think not the beach in plain sight. Like.
No, I wanted to keep jumping.
Just let me jump. Don't rain on my parade. Do you think the killer might have been hiding?
Brain blast.
He spent all the time thinking just to say something so pointless. How disappointing. Didn't I just say there was nowhere to hide? Do I have to explain it in another language so you can understand?
Sí, por favor.
Bien.
No hablo inglés.
Poquito. Her personality got a hell of a lot more forceful when she stopped being a suspect.
A suspect?
No, there should have been a place for them to hide. A place you didn't look, Kyoko.
You blind bitch.
What are you saying? Stop being annoying or I'm gonna make Akane bop you on the head and shut you up for good. I really don't want that to happen to me. I need to answer by any means. Slaps her. The place where the killer was hiding. The place where Kyoko hasn't looked is... In the other bathroom? The shower?
No. The shower she said she checked.
Oh, behind Mihiru?
Nope.
The closet?
Yep.
Yeah, but I thought Kyoko was in there.
Yes. But she big brain. She tiny brain, excuse me.
The killer was probably hiding in the closet.
She didn't check around her.
Oh. The closet? That's where I was locked up. After we woke up, you said you rushed out of there, right? Then you probably didn't look inside the closet very carefully.
But could two people even hide in such a small place? And without Kyoko ever knowing?
That's why the killer made sure to arrange a hiding place. Oh. If the killer made sure to arrange a hiding place in the house. You okay?
No, you're not okay.
Ah. It's the killer made sure to arrange a hiding place in advance. I can only think of one place. That's right. The place where the killer was hiding inside the closet was... In the boat thing?
Are you talking about this?
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is.
It's a surfboard case, I think. Yeah.
What about the surfboard case in the closet? I'm pretty sure they could have hidden in there. Huh? Inside the surfboard case? But the shelf it was on, it was pretty messy. Don't you think?
There it is. There it is. I heard it.
Two surfboards were stacked on the top shelf, and there were surfboards that weren't even in the case. The killer probably did that on purpose to secure a hiding place. Because we haven't been on this island that long, so the closet should have been that messy, I think. Then, the killer was close to me during that time? I don't know why I thought she fainted.
It looks like she did.
But no, like in the courtroom.
Ah. She just fell over.
Yeah, she just keeled.
Yep.
Yeah, they were quietly holding their breath and hiding very close to you. Ooh.
And Chiaki gets excited. Nap time, okay.
For real. She looks cute.
Yep.
It's kind of like in for a penny, in for a pound, so to speak.
Don't you mean it's always darkest under the lighthouse?
I shouldn't say things I don't understand, like, so to speak. Anyway, the killer hid silently, and after making sure Hyoko left, they finally left the surfboard case.
Their feet are poking out from that surfboard case.
They're doing a bad job. Hello?
I agree with that as well. Look at that.
Seriously, nobody asked what you think.
Nah, there's no way the killer would leave Hyoko by herself if they were trying to frame her. Like a picture. If Hyoko was left alone and ruined the evidence the killer had planted, it would have messed up their plan.
Yeah,
instead,
really
it
funny.
Makes more sense to think that the killer was hiding in the beach house, watching Hyoko sleep.
Instead of leaving a gummy bear as evidence, they just left the picture of Hyoko, like just a photo, and they were like, "Ah, yes, this will frame her." Like, the dumbest criminal.
I was fucking waiting for it. I was like, this is going somewhere.
Saying whatever you want, even if we didn't ask. Alright, if you don't want to freaking get punched, just stand still and let me punch you. My voice can't go normal today.
It's fine. That was good. As far as I could tell. Sounds like a good time.
Oh, shut up. Oh, you shut up. Then grit your teeth.
I don't eat grits. Sorry, Akane. It's not like that, you dumb bitch. Hey, Monokuma. Can I ask you something about... can I ask you about something that seems strange to me? My dyslexia kicked in. No, I believe Prince Shotoko was from the future. A man from the future is always directing the flow of history. I'll listen to your story about men from the future some other time, you creep. As I recall, the body discovery announcement is made when three or more people discover a body, correct? Is the killer also included among those three or more people? Well, that's true, but, well, something like that is basically what it's supposed to be. You don't sound very articulate. Speak up, you little bitch.
Jeez, you're pretty annoying for noticing something like that.
I know it sounds like an excuse, but the body discovery announcement isn't supposed to be used for deduction. It's intended to create a fair trial. It's supposed to let everyone know a body has been found.
So you're saying it's unfortunate that I used it for deduction. I understand your excuse, but... depending on who actually found the body, it's possible that your three or more people rule could be deadly.
Well, as long as I keep things ambiguous, I can respond to situations with some flexibility.
Flexibility, huh? Like to bend over a lot? You bitch! So what about this time? Is it three people including the killer or not?
Jeez, fine. You want me to say it? It doesn't include the killer this time, okay? All done.
Which means three people other than the killer discovered Mahiro's body.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. I just thought it was somewhat strong, eh? More importantly, let's get back to our original topic.
Why are you bringing pasta into this?
Look, I like pasta. Angel's hair?
You're the one who went on a tangent, you dumbass.
We were just saying the killer was hiding in the surfboard case, right?
And after Hyoko ran away, the killer got to enjoy the simple life of destroying evidence.
However, before we proceed any further... there's something we have to make clear. The killer blocked the roadside door with Mahiro's body before Hyoko ran away. But what about the blood?
Now that you mention it, that mystery hasn't been solved yet either.
It's going to be alright. If you guys have come to this far, I'm sure you can discover that answer too. Now let's start the argument, shall we?
Yay.
Yay, talking real fast.
Woo!
Shout, okay. What did the killer do with the blood on their body?
Maybe they simply washed it off. Almost said shower room.
They couldn't use the shower, right? So washing it off would have been impossible. Oops.
They didn't have to use the shower. Ah, what about the wetsuits in the closet?
I can't aim.
Maybe they were wore one when they moved the body. If they used something other than the shower, what did they do with the bloody wetsuit? I didn't even see that.
They cut it up and flush.
Oh, okay. I was like, that was really freaking fast.
As someone who flushes their shit every morning, I can declare it would definitely clog the toilet.
Maybe it's the other way around? Perhaps some other than the killer moved the body?
Maybe they were able to wash it off.
Wow.
If I use that person's opinion, I might be able to break through the contradiction.
Okay, it's definitely not the shower room, because that's our only bullet. So washing it off would have been impossible.
Mm.
Not the wetsuits.
I think
that's what it is.
Possibly. I think so.
I'm
not sure.
Come here, you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay.
Doesn't need to be the shower, you dumb fuck.
If they just needed to wash off the blood, they didn't necessarily have to use the shower. They could have just as easily used something else.
Like one of the Mr. Clean wash bars. I don't know what they're called. That.
That.
Something other than the shower. Like what?
Something other than the shower. The sea. No, the drinks inside the refrigerator.
Bam.
Is the only thing that I could think of. The drinks inside the refrigerator. Couldn't the killer have used those to wash off the blood?
Oh shit.
Oh. Jeez. What's her problem?
Oh god, I nearly went freaking the voice I used earlier today.
In theory, but that is impossible, you dumb fuck.
Well, por qué?
Try to remember the refrigerator carefully, and then you will understand that there's no possible way the drinks in the refrigerator were used.
Trash can?
I'm pretty sure. It's true, there were drinks in the beach house. However, I can't read these.
Oh.
Wouldn't be able to enough to wash off. Okay.
Sure. Yep.
I got it.
Fuck.
I wasn't even trying that hard and I got it.
We can't assume they used just one drink. They could have used a bunch of them to wash it off.
Thank God I could slow that down.
Didn't I say it was impossible? There's no water bottles in the freaking thing. Ah! There we go. If you use those to wash blood off, the blood won't come off all your body and it will get sticky. I can't. That one would be raised suspicion. Okay.
Oop. It's gonna be that the first.
Yeah, sorry, I'm too focused on cutting the shit out of this. My apologies.
Fuck her up! No, there were water bottles inside the refrigerator.
How many times do I have to tell you? There were no water bottles in there whatsoever.
That was after the incident, right? But before the incident, there were water bottles in the fridge. And the killer took all of those water bottles and used them to wash the blood off their body.
So you're saying the water bottles were gone because they were all used? That's a logical fallacy.
It's not a fallacy. There should have been evidence inside the trash can. Evidence like a lot of thrown away plastic water bottles Isn't that right, Chiaki?
Oh, you're right. These bottles look like they may have been filled with water.
Well, now that you mention it, why do I sound Western? When I went to the beach house a few days ago, I feel like I drank one of those plastic water bottles.
Because you're a thirsty bitch.
You know what? Soda is thirsty.
Yes. I get it.
You should have said so sooner.
Okay, this is where we're going to stop for now.
Oh, okay.
Do something
it.
Real quick. Thank y'all for watching. And we'll see you next time.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye now. Bye-bye.